Finally, we move on to the story of two friends who work in separate fields. They banded together to help keep some of their favorite restaurants afloat by selling t-shirts made especially for certain establishments close to their hearts. I spoke with Monica Magsanok and Audrey Mooney about their initiative called Takeout. Do watch this. Well, girls, talk to me about it. What exactly sparked this project in you both?
Manila Takeout is an initiative that pairs restaurants with designers. We create limited edition merchandise that is sold for the benefit of the restaurant staff and service team.
So basically, I work as an analyst, and most of the time, well, I cover mostly consumer stocks that include restaurants. So I kind of know how bad restaurants were hit. And I was telling Monica, you know, how we chat every day. I was telling her, like, oh, the restaurants are doing really bad, and our favorite restaurants are already closing. I want to do something. And Monica actually mentioned that something in New York, that the restaurants were actually also closing, but the difference was they had, like, different fundraisers, and one of them was making merchandise for the restaurant. So Monica was like, maybe we should do something like that here too.
It's funny because you did mention that you were an analyst of sorts. You're an investment analyst based here. Monica is an art director, and she's based in New York, but you girls have been going to school for years together, so you're great friends. And the reason why I think you chose to support restaurants is that that's where you guys converge.
For us, I think, like what you said, Monica and I have always loved going out. Like when she was here still in Manila, we'd always spend like Friday and Saturday together finding new bars and new restaurants. And so it's something that's, it's an industry that's like really close to us. And also, especially the waiters, we've actually become like their friends. We know their names because we go to the same places almost all the time.
And you each have a role to play in this project of yours. So Monica, you're in charge, since of course you're an art director, but you're based in New York. So you're in charge of finding the artists. Are you in touch with the artist community out here as well, even though you work all the way there?
Yes. I've only been in New York for a little less than a year. And I did plan to come back to Manila. So while Audrey's hobby would be finding new restaurants for us to eat at every weekend, new bars, my hobby is really just finding new talent on Instagram to connect with. I think Manila has such a vibrant creative community. And when Audrey and I were discussing this, we obviously started by thinking about our favorite restaurants and how I could help them personally by creating the merchandise and everything. But we decided that we'd love to help as many as we can. And I decided that I could reach out to a few of my friends who'd be interested as well. Friends that I know are very supportive of the local F&B industry. And we were just really lucky that they were able to donate their time and talent to our small initiative.
So when you talk about merchandise, what exactly are we looking at here? What are you selling so that you can help the different restaurants of your choosing?
Right now we're selling limited edition t-shirts. So we have each artist create the design and we print it on a t-shirt together with Manila Takeout, limited edition, everything available for 2 weeks on our website.
And how does it work? Because I know that you do choose the restaurants and you pair sort of the artist to the restaurant as well. So a limited edition t-shirt would be thematic for each restaurant. How does it work, Audrey?
Basically, we made it, we just make it available for 2 weeks because we want everyone to buy within those 2 weeks. And also, we made it limited edition and within that timeline. So we don't put a cap on the amount of shirts that people can actually buy, but we actually give a time limit, mainly because we didn't want competition between restaurants, and we wanted to keep each drop 4 to 5 restaurants only, mainly because we wanted to give attention to each restaurant, and so that when we move on to the next one, people could focus on that, on those restaurants also.
When you drop a collection, that's 4 different t-shirts, am I correct? Because they're related to 4 different restaurants.
Yes.
And how do you pair the artist to the restaurant? Is that some sort of serendipitous thing where the artist gets to choose, or is there like a special connection between the artist and the restaurant?
So we began by choosing restaurants that we kind of already had a connection with. And from there, we chose artists who we also knew had a special connection to this restaurant. So either a great personal experience, or so an artist whose maybe visual style echoes that of the brand of the restaurant. So for example, we had Marla Darwin come on board for El Chupacabra. She's had a lot of her birthdays there. She knows the owners personally. So everything just worked out really well immediately. But we've also had teams who we've matched just because of their visual style.
How do you choose the restaurants? I know that these are restaurants that you girls have dined in together that are sort of close to your hearts, and it echoes the story of the fact that some of them may not make it through this pandemic, unfortunately, but of course, hopefully with your help, they'll get to make it through.
Well, in the beginning, we chose basically the ones that meant something to us, or places you'd actually find me and Monica or us with our families. But then ever since we saw the traction, we found like it would be a good opportunity to actually include restaurants that are independent or neighborhood restaurants, because we think they're the ones that need the most help. So we choose the small restaurants that have a huge has a huge following or a loyal following, because I think these restaurants are important to help, mainly because we've seen them actually grow and work hard towards making a name for themselves in a very actually competitive industry here in Manila.
So how did your first collection go? I think that your first drop has already happened.
So yes.
You dropped out four restaurants. How does it go from how much the t-shirt is to when they get to collect, or when you get to give the restaurants whatever you've made from the merchandise, to where exactly the restaurant pushes it forward to?
Okay, so we sell the shirts for 800 pesos, and as we said on our website, all proceeds, all profits go to the restaurant, so that's actually 400 pesos profit for each shirt. And everything is made on a pre-order basis. So once everyone orders and we finish the two-week drop, we begin production, and production takes around 2 to 3 weeks. And after 2 to 3 weeks, we start to deliver them to our customers. And after the production is done and we've actually paid for the shirts already, that's when we transfer the raised funds to the restaurants.
Monica, this is not your first t-shirt project. I think you gave voice to a cause about a few years ago in 2016, you had an initiative as well. So can you talk to us about that? And what did you learn from that particular initiative that maybe you've applied to this one?
In 2016, I think I created a line of t-shirts in response to the infamous Marcos burial at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani. When the news broke, a lot of my friends my age were around 24, were tweeting and were Facebooking, putting up Facebook statuses about how disappointed they were in the administration and the decision. And I felt like I really just wanted to create, you know, a concrete way to change things, or a concrete way to support those affected by the injustice. So I just created a simple t-shirt that said Youth in Revolt, because that's how I felt our generation was kind of feeling, and I want what I wanted to convey. And I put it up on my Facebook just to sell to family and friends. But overnight, it kind of went viral, and we were able to reach a ton of different people. We were able to raise around 250,000 for the victims, for the families of the victims of martial law, which we donated through the Rock Ed Foundation. So coming from that project and taking on this one, Audrey and I realized that t-shirts are a really great product, maybe not a product, but a really great avenue for us to express support for a certain cause, a certain brand, and that it's very accessible. It's a t-shirt, anyone can wear it. You can wear it formally, you can wear it as quote-unquote pambahay while we're all in quarantine.
These artists, do they have a free hand at designing what they're supposed to design for each particular restaurant, or is there sort of like a collaboration happening between either you and the artist or the restaurant and the artist, or does the restaurant just get surprised?
Exactly. Because all work is a donation on the artist's end, we try to give them as much creative freedom as possible and to avoid revisions and extra work, because, you know, they are donating their time to the initiative. But before we begin any project, we always hop on a quick Zoom call with both of our partners to make sure that all the design expectations are aligned, and we kind of run ideas by each other so that the restaurant isn't surprised at the end by the output, and so that they definitely have a say in what it looks like. And we just want to make sure that overall it correctly represents their brand visually.
What has the restaurant's response been? What has their reaction been in terms of you guys wanting to help their industry out, even though you're not specifically part of those industries?
They've actually been very, very grateful. They always say thank you, and they're very supportive. So they actually share our page on social media. They even share the other restaurants. So it's kind of cool because we've created a community. So even when the first drop was done, the restaurants that were part of the first drop, they would share actually the ones in the second drop, because I think all of them are just like having a hard time and they all just want to help each other, and they're just extremely grateful for any support that we can actually get.
And our restaurants and perhaps even artists, the ones approaching you now, because I'm sure for the first bit, since it was a new idea, a new concept, you were the ones trying to find the artists. Of course, the restaurants were your choosing, but right now, are there artists saying, hey, I sort of want to get into this initiative?
Yes, we have a bunch of artists and restaurants who've approached us and asked us if they can join, and we definitely want to help as many people as we can. So we have a new way to group our restaurants now. We've been starting to do it by theme. So unofficially, the last release was sort of where we would have dinner, where we could go out with friends and family, you know, or on dates, or, you know, very unofficial. But our next release is actually something with bars, because we think, you know, especially because now we can't drink, there's the liquor ban, much harder and to survive as a bar now. So we've grouped a bunch of the bars and we will be releasing that next week.
Do you see this project going on for quite a while?
Well, we do. As of now, we plan to do maybe three more drops after next week. But then it depends on if people are still buying shirts, if we can still help some more. Of course, we'll keep it going as long as we can still help restaurants. So yeah, we're not really sure yet. We actually have a lot of friends doing different causes. They have different fundraisers. Like my sister, she's younger, maybe 3 years younger, and she's actually doing, she actually had a fundraiser for getting laptops and internet for kids of staff in our school. Or we have friends who actually have initiatives for the environment. So I think everyone has their own type of initiative and whatever means closest to them.
And when people ask you why restaurants, I mean, you've explained it to me, but I guess people assume that you would stay closest to what you know in terms of maybe the art industry or even finance or whatever industry you're in. What do you tell them?
I think personally, anyone who knows me knows that I actually really love restaurants and bars. Like, people come to me to plan their dates or plan their birthdays. So I think it's, and even when we go abroad, when me and Monica go abroad, when we plan our trips, I think some people plan to go to Disneyland. We actually have like a Google Doc of like a list of restaurants and bars to go to. So I think it's really something that we've always enjoyed and we want to give back to.
Monica?
Yes, exactly. Same as Audrey. And while Audrey takes care of the restaurants, I really enjoy finding new artists to work with, to collaborate with. I think, you know, it shouldn't be a competition among the different creatives in the industry. And I like bringing them together. As Audrey said, we created a little community of artists and restaurants who are just so supportive of each other. And we'd love to keep that going. As with Takeout, the initiative isn't just about creating shirts or creating merchandise. I think it's more about bridging different disciplines and kind of uniting Philippine talent across industries. So right now we're doing restaurants and designers, but later on we'd love to do something more long-term, more sustainable, but still exploring the idea of an ecosystem with collaboration among industries.
Sustainable is a buzzword in terms of these things, because you can put up a nice project that helps maybe for a while, mm-hmm. but how do you make it go the long haul? So sustainability seems to be something that still has to be worked out by a lot of these smaller, like independent, beautiful projects like yours. So you do see it going far enough?
Exactly. I think once we exhaust this model, I mean, the t-shirt model, we do want to explore the idea of collaborating with different industries. So Audrey and I are still working out the dynamics, but we know that we have to kind of transform it and keep the concept of collaboration, but change the different kind of people that we work with or the industries that we work with. So we're looking into that.
Your generation is so good at knowing what you're passionate about and just going for it. I think that's part of the beauty of the younger generation now. Do you feel that, because a lot of the initiatives are from people your age, if not younger, do you feel that this is really a trait that you guys have?
I feel like we were raised by a great generation. So thank you to our parents and everything. But I think as a generation now, we just see all the things that are happening around us. We have, you know, the lockdown, we have all the injustice, and we just feel that you know, if no one else is going to do anything about it, then we have the responsibility. We believe that if we have the power to do anything, then we should take it upon ourselves to try and change things. I think that's the view that's shared by people my age and people from our generation.
So what would your advice be to maybe young people out there who have the passion, they want to do something because I guess they're cooped up at home, because you guys have created this whole project from the confines of your homes. Mm-hmm. So what advice would you give them to say, you know what, anything's possible. I mean, you guys have done it, right?
In any project, I think it's important to actually find a problem, because I think to make an initiative very successful, we actually have to find a problem. And with that problem, you have to figure out small solutions to it and actually find, enjoy it also, but at the same time, just make sure that you're actually trying to solve a problem. I think that's what makes our initiative very interesting to people, because they actually see the problem that we're solving. So, yeah.
And Monica?
I think with our generation, we have access to so many different forms of media that weren't available before. I mean, we've had, before it was just print or maybe online, very basics online, but now we have Zoom, we have Instagram, we have just websites. So there's so many different avenues that can be explored in terms of promotion or in terms of initiatives. So I think find one that you kind of already integrate yourself with in daily life, or something that you already have ready, and just find a way to put your personality into that, your passions into that. And other people will just feel it too. Like what Audrey said, this initiative is kind of successful just because it's very relatable to people. We know that they want to support their favorite places. And I think if you do have passion, just find a way to put it out there and it will be well received.
Finally, what are your messages, just really briefly, to the different restaurants that you're supporting, or the restaurant industry, the food industry in general? Because I know that they're really hurting. And a lot of the people commiserate with them, but we're hoping that they all pull through.
Well, to our past partners, we'd like to say thank you so much for trusting us with this initiative. And to all the other restaurants, we'd love to collaborate with you, and we'd want to help out as much people as we can. So just reach out to us and email us at hello@manilatakeout.com.
And how do they find you, Monica? I mean, I'm sure you're all over social media, but maybe you can just direct us to the page.
Of course, sure.
You want to check out the shirts, or do they have to order in advance for the next drop? How does it work?
We'll be releasing our next line of shirts next weekend, and you can check us out on Instagram at @manila_takeout, or you can visit our website to purchase the shirts, www.manilatakeout.com.
Girls, thank you so much for joining me today, and all the best to your initiative. Stay home, stay safe.
Thank you so much.